Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition Referee Training Videos, designed for both referees and teams to learn from. This is Chapter 6, Tipping, Entanglement, and Damage. Tipping. And damage. Are pretty easy to notice and define, but entanglement may not be so easy. So here is a definition of entanglement. A robot is considered to have entangled an opposing robot if it has grabbed or hooked the opponent robot. Further, Rule G12 states that incidental tipping, entanglement, and damage is expected. However, intentional or egregious tipping, entanglement, and damage are illegal. To be in violation of Rule G12, a robot must intentionally or egregiously tip over an opposing robot, intentionally or egregiously grab or hook an opposing robot, or intentionally or egregiously damage an opposing robot. These sorts of actions don't happen very often, but when they do, they can be critical. In conjunction with G12, it's also important teams don't violate R3, which states that devices that could damage the field, those that could damage other robots, or those that pose an unnecessary risk of entanglement are not permitted. Pertaining to R3, there's one specific device worth mentioning. Some teams have discussed having a tether made of items like zip ties, chain, or PWM cables that allows them to connect multiple sections of a robot together. Any non-rigid device for this purpose would be in violation of R3C, and thus illegal. To avoid being ruled as an unnecessary entanglement risk, make sure any sort of attaching device is rigid and unlikely to be caught in another robot. That's all for Chapter 6. But make sure you check out other chapters on various specific refereeing issues.